Kia ora tago, I'm Roger.
I'm James.
And I'm using Stick Figment and Roundup. Starts now.
Blues and Gold Awards. If you know someone who's done particularly well in either sporting, cultural, community sphere, this is your chance to give them the recognition they deserve. There is a ton of categories and potential awards, so find out more information in the description below. Considering this is the highest award in sporting, cultural, or community offered in Otago, this is the ultimate opportunity to celebrate the achievements of our peers.
This week is OUSA's annual diversity week. We've got a ton of events lined up, from safe sex workshops to dancing and heels classes to beer and board game night potlucks to intercultural communication workshops to even, get this, a human library.
Wow.
If any of this sounds interesting or fun to you, check these out in the link in the description, or keep an eye out on campus. This is a great chance to immerse yourselves in the diversity that Otago is so proud of. So go to an event, or two, or ten, and get amongst.
So we had Hannah Morgan come by to the executive meeting to tell us about her fundraising event for the Mental Health Foundation and OUSA's peer support program. She will be swimming the Fogo Strait from Bluff to Stewart Island. There's 130 kilometres, no wetsuit, no help. I think the first time this was swum, according to the script, is 7th of February 1963 at a time of 13 hours
but
and 40
actually
minutes.
Actually nuts.
Yeah, we formally supported her 100% and thank you for coming along. And if you want to follow her journey, we'll chuck the link to her Instagram and Facebook in the description of this video.
We signed a memorandum of understanding with the Otago Southern Campus.
So after discussion regarding the current status of OUSA election tickets, the executive had directed the OUSA Policy Committee to keep the ticket system the way it is and rebalance the power and difference between larger tickets and individual candidates. Yep. It's about getting that balance between allowing students the freedom to form their own groups, but also preventing that from significantly disadvantaging individual candidates.
Yep. And in regards to the formal complaint from last week, the exec noted, received and accepted the complaints towards Curio and the exec. And as a remedy, Curio has accepted to meet with President Katie and Admin Vice President Cammy fortnightly to check in on the work that he has done.
So OUSA's corporate support review is coming up, and the exec decided what times they're going to meet and weigh in on it.
And we received CEO Debbie Downs' June report, and received and accepted Welfare Officer Abby's committee report.
And we also accepted the minutes for the Welfare Committee.
Done.
So as always, thank you very much everyone for coming along, watching our OUSA exec recaps. Congratulations to
Abby Fellatos.
Buy yourself a $20 voucher to Reburger. You can pick it up from the OUSA main office reception.
For a chance to win yourself a $20 voucher for either Reburger or Char Time, comment down below telling us
what you think of RAs at colleges. Are they great? Are they bad? Are they fantastic? Should they be paid more? Whatever you want to say, chuck it in the description. Let us know. So, if you've got any questions about anything we've talked about this week,
feel free to hit us up on the streets.
Check us out at the OUSA main office outside, beside UBS on campus. Hit us on Snapchat at OUSAExec. You can email us at campaigns@ousa.org.nz or education@ousa.org.nz, or you can email the president directly at president@ousa.org.nz.
The point of these videos is to give you guys an update on what we've been up to and to fill you in on the meetings, so that way you don't have to go to them.
Ka kite, thank you very much.
Cheers, guys. Because by all means, if we don't get this done, it's fine. We can always call someone in.
What a
I'm just saying how I see it, okay.
What an absolute
In 3, 2,
such a
1. Kia ora, Otago!